Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 16 Beta 3 and iOS 15.6 Beta 5 have been out for a few days, and we're going to talk about the overall experience, but first let's talk about new features found in iOS 16, as there's quite a few new ones, and we'll go over that. Then later we'll talk about the overall experience of both of the betas, and then also we'll talk about when to expect iOS 16's public beta and iOS 15.6's public release. But first let's talk about what's new. The first thing has to do with even if you're on iOS 15.5 or any of these betas, in maps, you'll start to see some updated maps in New Zealand, Monaco, and France. So in major cities, you'll start to see the updated experience like we have in big cities such as New York City, San Francisco, and other places. I wasn't able to see this yet in New Zealand, but you may be starting to see this in even iOS 15.5, where you'll have additional building detail, new updates with maybe look around, and much more. Now, as far as new features in 16 Beta 3, there's over 20 of them, and the first one has to do with the home screen. If we press and hold, or haptic press, the animation is a little bit different. It resembles what we had with 3D Touch. So if I do the same thing on Beta 2, we'll press and hold on the App Store here, it just sort of bounces out. On Beta 3, it's a little bit slower and looks more like a 3D Touch. It's very slight, but definitely different as you press and hold on an icon. So it's something they've updated. I would love to have a pressure sensitive screen back with 3D Touch, but I don't think we're going to have that. If we go into our wallpapers, there's some new changes there. So if we go in, maybe add a new one, we'll wait for it to load here. It takes a second sometimes. And if we go into the astronomy wallpaper and then just go to Earth, they've actually centered Earth this time around. And as you can see with Beta 2 on the left, Beta 3 on the right, the Earth is now more centrally located on the lock screen or the home screen. So it now covers up the area where there's bottom widgets where it didn't before. Small updates, but it's something a little bit new. Also, I talked about in the initial What's New video, a new Clownfish wallpaper, and it finally showed up the day after installing this. It actually took a day. I tried to restart, it didn't show, but if we go into our wallpaper, scroll all the way down, scroll to the right, we have the new Clownfish wallpaper. This is a remake of an original wallpaper on the first iPhone. So you can see here, it's sort of 3D depth mapped, and it looks really good. This was not one that I actually ever used, but it's available now if you want to use it. And if you're not seeing it, try rebooting. And I just put it on the charger, woke up in the morning, and it was there. So it may show up, it may not. When you're adding a widget to the home screen, you can see we have different options. And if we go into some of them, they've rearranged the order of many of them. So from symbols on Beta 2 to watch list on Beta 3, and you'll see it's just sort of the other way around on Beta 3. This is true when we go into different things such as weather and others also. So some of the options are a little bit different as far as their overall order for some reason. So Apple may continue to update this. So fitness here, you'll see some of them are identical, others are not. So summary, climate, and you'll see again, it's in a different order. If you're playing music in the music app, so we'll just press play, go into Spotlight search. It might take a moment. We'll try it again. And you'll see now it says now playing. Sometimes this shows up and it's showing the actual artist that's playing right now in the music app. You can tap on this for more information about that artist. So it's something a little bit new, and sometimes it shows up, sometimes it doesn't, like I showed you there, but it's something new. And thanks to Dakota for pointing that out. Also, when you're playing music, if you go into the control center, tap on the music that's playing. If you press on the album or the title, it actually has a pressed state, but it doesn't really do anything but bring you back. So it actually shows that you're pressing something where it didn't do that before. If we go into settings, go to our notifications, scroll all the way to the bottom, you'll see there's now test alerts. This is something new in Beta 3 that we don't have in Beta 2. It's just test alerts. If you want to hear those, you can turn it on or leave it off. When you're using Siri on your phone, but you're using it with the word hey in front of it to activate, it now has a new sound. It sounds very similar to what we have with dictation. So if I go into Safari, activate dictation, you can hear the sound here. The same is true when you're using CarPlay. So if we go into CarPlay, when you're in Apple CarPlay, the Siri sound is different as well. So I'll go ahead and press on the home button here. You can hear again. So it's a slightly updated sound. If we go into settings, go down to accessibility, under accessibility, scroll down to live captions. If you look at the live captions icon, it's actually a new icon. It's been changed a little bit from beta 2 to beta 3, and there's also additional options for live captions. So you'll see if we go under appearance, we now have bold text and text size along with idle opacity. So this is a small change, but something they've updated. And then also when you activate live captions, so we'll turn it on here. You can see it now says listening instead of waiting. We have the same controls and everything where we can sort of minimize this off to the side, but we now have it just saying listening instead of waiting. Additionally, under accessibility, if we go under touch, go to assistive touch, then go to customize top level menu. Under top level menu, there's now a new option for continuous scroll. So if you add an icon, tap on the icon, scroll down, and keep going until you get to scroll gestures and you'll see continuous scroll. That's new. It wasn't there before. Again, in settings, if we scroll down to Safari, under Safari, scroll down, you'll see we have tabs here. This is a pretty minor change and it's easier to see if I turn light mode back on. So we'll turn that back on the beta 3 device, and you'll see where it says tab bar and single bar, the colors are a little bit different, where tab bar is outlined and single tab is just black and white or gray on beta 3. In the Books app, they've updated this again. And before, they actually got rid of turning pages where you could just turn the page. It sort of slides, but it's not the same page turn. Hopefully they bring that back. Now we have a little X in the upper right where we can actually close out of the book. And then down at the bottom, if we tap on the options here on beta 3, we can now scroll. So we can scroll through everything, and it's just an easy way to see all of the different contents without tapping on contents. So it's a small change, but something that's a little bit different in beta 3. Now I mentioned in the initial What's New video that Apple added the shared photo library. Now I have it turned on, and if we go into the camera, there's some new options. So you'll see here, there's a little icon with some people here. So if we want to take a photo, it will automatically share to the shared photo library. Just turn on the toggle and it says shared library. Turn it off and you can leave it off and just share what you want individually. The same is true when you go into your photos. So if we go into photos, here's the wallpaper from today, and I actually took this picture, and you'll see here in the upper right, if we tap on the three dots, we now have the option to move to shared library. So that's something a little bit new where you have that option. If you want to move them individually, you can choose to share all of them or just some of them. Also, if we have a bunch of duplicate photos, there's something new there as well. So you'll see we have some duplicates. They're a little bit different as far as the photos, but we'll tap on merge and then we'll merge these two duplicates. We'll merge both. And there's a little animation change. Let me show you that one more time. We'll merge these. And you'll see there's a little animation at the bottom on beta 3. It's a small update, but something they've changed. Within Fitness Plus, if you're using that on the Fitness app, there's some new awards that have been added with iOS 16. So they continue to update these, so they may look a little bit different than iOS 15. So that's a small change that may have been there in previous betas, but it's updated now. Also within the Watch app, I noticed family watches showing up. I didn't see this before I had to go into all watches and they were there. If you've seen this, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you're watching a video on your iPhone with the Photos app, you can see the media controls are now on the upper left. This is a little bit different than before, where beta 2, they're in the top right. So they've just changed them around and then sort of split them where they've kept edit on the right and then some of the controls on the left with beta 3. Now, if you have a cellular data plan and you're using a physical SIM, there's now an option to convert to eSIM. You could set it up as an eSIM before, but now you'll see convert to eSIM. I thought I saw this on a previous beta, but it looks like it's new in beta 3 and showing up all the time. And thanks to Matt for sending this in. If you're using Stage Manager on an iPad that supports it, and maybe you go into Safari, if you have an app on here that's meant for an iPhone, such as Instagram, that will now run in its own window. So you'll see I can drag that on top of another window, such as Safari, and I have access to Instagram. I can scroll through it just like it was an iPhone app, but on the iPad in its own window. You can't really resize it much. You could bring it full screen, but you're not allowed to really change much of it. But this works for any app that's only meant for iPhone. So it's great to see this update. So again, if we want to bring this back, we can just drag it over to the side and then use Stage Manager like normal. Also, if we want to close a window, Command W now works. We can just close windows like we can on the Mac. So they've added that shortcut, which is nice. Also, when you're connected to an external monitor, the monitor now has squared off edges where sometimes before it was more of a rounded corner. This is something they've updated with beta 3 and looks to be performing like you would expect on a normal monitor. So before it would be just a rounded corner, although it's a little buggy where it will sort of flash from a rounded corner to a squared off corner. I expect this will be fixed later on. On Apple Watch with watchOS 9 beta 3, there's a small animation change when you're clearing water from the speaker. So if we tap on the little water drop here, press and hold the digital crown, you can see the animation is different. So it says keep holding, and you'll see there's little bubbles and more. And thanks to Brahm from TechRender for pointing this out. So not a ton of changes with watchOS, but that's probably the major thing there. Now, as far as the overall experience of iOS 16 beta 3, I've heard everything from it being very good to it still being incredibly buggy. For me, iMessage continues to have an issue with group conversations where they sometimes completely lose their text box and I can't enter it. Then sometimes it comes back. So if I go into messages, you can see at the bottom, there's no way to actually input text. So my brother was actually building a PC, reinstalling Windows, and it's just not working properly. So as you can see, I can't enter text. Other than that, sometimes setting wallpapers is still a little bit buggy, where if you go into the lock screen and try and set a wallpaper, sometimes it just doesn't work properly or it completely blanks out. So if we cancel this, sometimes go back to a different one, go to customize. Sometimes the home screen wallpaper will just be completely black and it doesn't work properly. So that's something I've seen over and over that continues to come back. I'm sure they'll fix this by the time it's released. Also, additionally, people are saying that some apps are still crashing, banking apps aren't working, and the iPhone is getting pretty warm sometimes when processing. If you're using accessibility features such as voice dictation and things like that, or just having the overall live captions beta, the processor will get quite warm and it will heat up. That's pretty normal for when you're using accessibility features that use a lot of processing power, but in general, it definitely is a little bit warmer than you can normally expect when you're using it. That again will be resolved by the time it's released to the public. As far as iOS 15.6 beta 5, that actually seems to be very, very solid and stable. Most people say it's the best version of iOS 15, and it should be. There's very few issues, and it definitely has pretty good battery life, according to many people, where it's easily getting people through the day without a problem. So I would expect that to be very solid. As far as iOS 16, well, it's a beta and an early beta, and the battery life for me has not been great. Just today, I'm down to 67%. And it's actually been on the charger for only, or off of the charger for only about 5.5 hours. So if we go into settings, go to battery, battery health is still at 100%. You can see my overall capacity here using Coconut Battery. That's a free app you can download on the Mac, but it's outside of the App Store. Then if we go into my battery life, you can see here over the last 10 days, I used 75% of my battery yesterday and had 4 hours and 53 minutes of screen on time, 4 hours and 40 minutes of screen off time. So not really that great on a 13 Pro Max. And again, the same is true for the iPad. On iPadOS 16 Beta 3, it seems to be fairly stable, other than maybe a few issues here and there with apps not running. But in general, it's pretty stable. We'll wait for this to run and you'll see over the last 10 days, I had 2 to 5 hours of screen on time total between charging. So again, not getting me through a day, but this has been a problem for me with iOS 15 betas as well. And again, you can see my battery capacity and everything here. It's not 100% on my iPad, but I've had this for quite some time and charged it quite a few amount of cycles and use it regularly every day. Now, as far as if you should install iOS 16 beta 3, at this point, I would wait for the public beta unless you're a developer. Apple said it will be out in July. That means maybe this week since we had beta 3, although it could be a couple weeks away, but based on what we've had before, it seems likely maybe sometime next week. However, they haven't announced it officially. However, we're also expecting iOS 15.6 RC this week as well. I would expect the release candidate early in the week with maybe a final release later in the week or the following week. That makes a lot of sense. Then we'll move on to iOS 15.7 betas where they'll continue to refine iOS 15 all the way up until September where we'll have a final release of iOS 16. So usually we'll have the last update of iOS 15 or previous versions at the end of August with a final version of iOS 16 released to the public, usually in mid-September around the launch of the iPhone 14. So 14, 14 Pro, 14 Max, and 14 Pro Max. That's what I would expect with that. As far as the YouTube community poll and comments, let's go into that. Now, at the time of this video, you can see there's almost 8,000 votes. So thanks to everyone that voted. And there's also 82 comments. Prior to making this video, I went in, looked at all the different comments to see what the overall experience is like on iOS 16 and iOS 15.6. And you'll see 26% are currently on iOS 16 beta 3, 8% are on iOS 15.6 beta 5. And you'll see that's up quite a bit from the prior week. So we're going up about 5% with iOS 16 betas. We've actually gone down with iOS 15 betas, but not everyone has voted yet. Also, those using the public version is at 58%. 1% are using iOS 14.8 or older, and 7% are using Android. Now let's read a few comments. Gary Sarig Joseph says, I'm running iOS 16 beta 3 on my iPhone 12 Pro Max with very few issues. It almost feels like a full release and I'm enjoying it very much. Even my banking apps work just fine and notifications stack nicely on the lock screen. And you'll see there's very different experiences depending on who it is. TJ Tomasetti said, 16 beta 3 on my 13 mini and a few bugs and glitches, but slowly getting better. Same goes with battery, although it's still pretty bad compared to 15 stable. That's my only major complaint, but it's a beta. Pravi Pravalika says, system crash with an incoming call while gaming 16 beta 3. So the experience is going to vary very much so depending on what you're using, what apps you're using, what you're doing. And so make sure you report that in the feedback app. Sherman West says, using iOS 15.6 beta 5 on an iPhone 13 Pro Max has been great so far, so good. Just going to hang in there until the iOS 16 public release is to come out in September. Jeff Broom says, iOS 16 beta 3 on my 11 Pro Max, battery life seems a little better, was horrible on beta 1 and 2. Music continues to occasionally pause itself or crash. Those have been my major issues, but other than that, the new features are fantastic and it's snappy fast. Looking forward to future betas. Noah Messer says, iOS 16 beta 3 on my 13 Pro Max has been pretty good. Just a few minor UI bugs, but nothing too bad. Performance is really good. Battery life is slowly but surely getting better. Can't wait for future versions of iOS 16 updates. And so that's everything with iOS 16 beta 3 and 15.6 beta 5. Of course, there's probably more features, and if I find more, I'll be sure to share them in a different video. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description. This is actually within the neighborhood I live in, so it's just a photo I took some time ago with an iPhone, but hopefully you enjoy it. And let me know if you want to see more of these landscape style wallpapers, maybe in future videos. But of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.